So to use this tool on the bond, it is a little differently, but let me show you. I'm using the same chart. I'm on the last row here. I already have my prong set up to move the needles that would be the contrasting color, hence the X's. So again, I have three needles on each end that are plain knit, just so I could differentiate them. And then you're going to take the points and put it behind the needle. Try to get it right in that slot and bring the needles forward. Because the bond will not knit the needles that are in holding position, I have my front levers now forward or away from me. So now it's going to knit these stitches, these needles, but not these. So I knit across. And then I have the contrast and color yarn on the floor. And I'm going to take and wrap it on the needle and just hand knit these stitches. Now you want to make them as close as the size of the contrast, actually that would be the main color, I guess, the first color you just knitted. You do not want to go and pull it way back because it's going to make that stitch really big. And there, I got one row done. So again, I am going to take my tool. I got 1, 2, 3, the first one's down, so I get it behind. And if I look, I could see that it is the needles that have the pink yarn on it. Again, I'm going to knit across with the blue, and then I'm just going to hand knit these stitches in pink. And when you look at the blue stitch, you could gauge how far to pull that needle back to make the pink stitches as uniform as the blue stitches. So now to do the first row to finish off this design again. The first prong is down, the second one is up, third one is down. I skip two, one, skip two, one, skip one, one, skip one, one, skip one. One, two. Skip one, one. Skip two. One. Skip two, one, skip one, one. And as I said, these prongs don't really line up the greatest, but I could see that I do have it right there. So I have the first one down. I skipped the first three because those are blue. And I found by putting whatever prong on the left here where it needs to be and just kind of push this over, just in case yours is off a little bit. Actually, I had it too much. There, now it's selecting the right needles. So I knit across in the blue. I hand knit the pink. And actually, because this is the same, two rows are the same, I could go ahead and bring these needles right back out after I knit them. That way I don't have to get the tool out. Only because this one here is doing two rows exactly the same. So I knit across with the blue, hand knit with the pink. Now I only did one repeat of this, so I had 24 stitches for the design, but then three needles on each side. So I had the 13 needles all together, It's really up to you, but I would suggest having at least two needles added or one needle added on the end for the seam allowance when you're making this for a sweater. And there, I'm all done.